أشراف مطلب وطالبه لله أكرام من يمشي على قدم. العلم نور مبين يستضيء به أهل السعادات والجهال في الظلم.
The next chapter. باب الكلام. مهدي باب الكلام. طيب. تعريفه كلام. It's important to know. تفضل. Yeah. لا علة أن سبب الشيخ رحمه الله doesn't mention it, so we're going to skip it. لكن we studied it earlier on when we studied the book. We studied. لكن here we don't have time for it to go study. Go on. علم ضروري, that which is kind of متواتر. نعم, that which is متواتر, that you don't really need evidence for. Meaning, you don't really need, if hadith is متواتر, then more often than not, you don't really need to look at every chain of narration on its own. طيب تعريفه الكلام. لا لا, وهم doesn't come under جهل مركب, although it is similar to جهل مركب, لكن it is a mistake that he has made. لكن this one, it is not a mistake that he has made according to him. لكن they are similar. الكلام, why is كلام important? باب الكلام. كلام is the speech that the Sheikh is going to talk about now. And this is important to know because أصول الفقه is derived from four things. From the Quran, the Sunnah, the ahkam of the sharia and اللغة العربية. It is derived from the Arabic language. That's why it says عموم وخصوص والعام والخاص والمقيد والمطلق. These are what? Wordings pertaining to the actual language. So the Sheikh says تعريفه, the تعريف of كلام. الكلام لغة, اللفظ الموضوع للمعنى. It is the speech that is put there. It is placed for a meaning. واصطلاحا, it is اللفظ المفيد. اللفظ المفيد. The wording that benefits. مثل الله ربنا تبارك وتعالى. Allah is our Lord. That is beneficial. You know what I mean when I say it to you. طيب. ومحمد النبينا. And Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is our Prophet. So the lafd al-mufid is that which the one that is talking is able to stop on it, and the one that is being spoken to, the one that is being spoken to, can understand and have a full meaning. مثلا, I said to you, دخل محمدٌ, Muhammad entered. I can stop there and you have a full meaning, صح? طيب, what about if I say to you, إذا دخل محمدٌ مع الطلاب, مفيد هذا? Is that beneficial? لا, it's not beneficial. Because you're still going to be saying, طيب, what? Because I said to you, إذا دخل محمد مع الطلاب, if Muhammad enters with the students, you're still what? Saying, what? What shall I do if Muhammad does enter with the students? So I can't stop on it, nor can you, what? Can you understand anything? So that is the meaning of اللفظ المفيد. وأقل ما يتألف منه الكلام اسمان, فعل واسم. فعل واسم. And the least that a كلام can consist of is a فعل and an اسم, an action and a name. مثال الأول, محمد رسول الله, صح؟ خطأ هذا. محمد رسول. It should be محمد رسول because it is two. And he's given an example of two. لكن محمد رسول الله consists of three words, مضاف مضاف إليه. So محمد رسول. So Allah, in that, the lafd al-jalal should not be there. It should say رسول. ومثال ثاني, استقام محمد. Muhammad stood. وواحد الكلام كلمة. كلام is plural. One of the كلام is كلمة. وهي اللفظ الموضوع لمعنى المفرد. وهي اسم أو فعل أو حرف. كلمة simply means the specific wording or a particle that is used for pointing towards a name or a thing or pointing towards an action or a حرف, a letter. The Sheikh says رحمه الله, فالاسم اسم is ما دل على معنى في نفسه من غير إشعار بزمن. اسم, a name, is that which shows you a meaning of its own. محمد, زيد, أحمد. لكن it is nothing to do with زمن, before or after. يعني مثلا, I say to you المسجد, you can't say to me when, because masjid is just an اسم. وهو ثلاثة أنواع, it is of three types. الأول ما يفيد العموم. الأول ما يفيد العموم is that which brings about necessity and we benefit from generality. كالأسماء الموصولة, الذين, الذي, التي. All of these are called أسماء موصولة. طيب, a lot of these مباحث now you've probably studied in نحو. الثاني ما يفيد الإطلاق, ما يفيد إطلاق. كالنكرة في سياق الإثبات, كالنكرة, when something is a نكرة في سياق الإثبات. مثلا أكرم طالبا, أكرم طالبا. أو الثالث ما يفيد الخصوص كالأعلام, that which A name can also be something which is specific. مثلا محمد علي is only one person. It could only be one person. والفعل ما دل على معنى في نفسه وأشعر بهيئته بأحد الأزمنة الثلاثة. As for a فعل, it is that which points towards an action that is done in one of three times. Past, present, or future. والفعل ما دل نعم. وهو إما ماض كفهم. ماض فهم. He understood. أو مضارع يفهم. He understands. أو أمر افهم. It is a command. والفعل بأقسامه يفيد الإطلاق لا فلا عموم له. When you come across a فعل, it just shows that it is unrestricted. لكن it doesn't show generality. That's why when we were studying the chapter of عام, remember he says اللفظ المستقرق لجميع ما وضع له. صح؟ اللفظ, the wording. So actions do not take generality. So مثلا the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did something, it doesn't mean that it shows a generality in that action. جيم. والحرف حرف is ما دل على معنى في غيره. A حرف is that which gives you a meaning, but only when it is put into something else. So اسم gives you a meaning of itself. صح؟ When I say to you masjid, you know exactly what I'm referring to. صح؟ A building that is used for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, when I say to you ذهب, you know that I'm referring to someone that went. يذهب, he goes. اذهب, I'm commanding you to go now. لكن as for a حرف, you can't understand it alone. من, في, با, has no meaning. لكن when you take it and you put it into something else, in another sentence or in another word, then you have a complete meaning. والواو, مثلا, for example, الواو. واو تأتي عاطفة. واو comes as a عاطفة فتفيد الاشتراك بين المتعاطفين في الحكم. So it shows that the two people that are the two things that are mentioned together, they share the same ruling. دخل محمد وأحمد ودخل محمد وعلي. Who entered? Ali and Muhammad. It just shows that they share, that they both entered the building. صح؟ ولا تقتضي الترتيب. لكن it doesn't show who came first. مثلا if I say to you دخل مودود وعلي. If I give you that example, does it show that Ali came before Mawdud or Mawdud came before Ali? لا, it doesn't. And this is important to know because that's where you differentiate between fa. ولا تنافيه إلا بدليل. لكن it doesn't negate it. Muhammad could have come in before Ali. It doesn't affirm it, nor does it negate it. والفاء, as for فاء, it also comes عاطفة. It also comes to show that something is done with the previous thing. It's connected. فتفيد الاشتراك في المتعاطفين في الحكم مع الترتيب. So فاء, it shows that they share the same حكم, لكن it also shows it was done in order. دخل محمد فسعيد. دخل محمد, محمد entered فسعيد, then سعيد entered. So you know that Muhammad came before what? Before the second person. طيب, نعم. وتأتي سببية, and it comes as a reason. It comes as a to make something a reason. نعم. لا تسهر فتضيع الصلاة. فتضيع الصلاة. Do not stay awake so that you miss Salat al-Fajr, for example. أو التعليل, or a reasoning. اللام الجارة. لام, that is a جارة. طيب. ولها معانٍ, and it has different means. التعليل وتمليك والإباحة. لام also has different meanings. And the benefit of knowing these حروف is what? When you're studying the أحكام of the شريعة, it comes with what? حروف. It comes with حروف. وعلى المولود وعلى الناس. صح؟ So these letters, when they come in the Sharia, they have a meaning. منها التعليل, a reasoning. التمليك, هذا لمحمد. Who does it belong to? محمد. هذا لمحمد. طيب. على الجارة, ولها معاني منها الوجوب. And على also has different meanings. الكتاب على الطاولة. The kitab is on the table. طيب. أو عليك فعل هذا. Upon you is to do that. Meaning it is what? واجب upon you. أقسام الكلام. أقسام الكلام. كلام ينقسم الكلام أو ينقسم الكلام باعتبار إمكان وصفه بالصدق وعدم إلى قسمين. خبر وإنشاء. كلام from another angle is divided into two. خبر وإنشاء. لكن when we're talking about believing it and not believing it. Not believing in it. He says فالخبر خبر is ما يمكن أن يوصف بالصدق أو الكذب لذاته. ما يمكن أن يوصف. خبر is what? That which is possible for you to say it is true, or it is possible for you to say it is not what? It is not true. لكن looking at the statement itself. فخرج بقولنا. What does it exclude? ما يمكن أن يوصف بصدق. When we say it is possible to describe it as truth or false, الإنشاء. لأنه لا يمكن فيه ذلك. لأن فإن مدلوله ليس مخبرا عنه حتى يمكن أن يقال إنه صدق أو كذب. مثلا it excludes إنشاء, that which is the opposite to it. For example, stand up. If I say to you stand up, you can't say to me you're lying. Or if I say to you sit, you can't say to me you're lying. Lying what? I haven't told you anything. I've commanded you with something. وخرج بقولنا لذاته, in of itself, الخبر الذي لا يحتمل الصدق أو لا يحتمل الكذب باعتبار المخبر به. لكن when we say لذاته, it excludes the khabar of the one that it is not possible to say it is a mistake or it is lying and so on and so forth. وذلك أن الخبر من حيث المخبر به ثلاثة أقسام. Because khabar is of three types when you're looking at the one that is informing you of it. الأول ما لا يمكن وصفه بالكذب. It is that which is not possible to be described as a lie. Like كخبر الله ورسوله الثابت عنه. Like the information or the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that which Allah jalla wa ala informs us about, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informs us about. It is not possible to say يحتمل الخطأ or يحتمل الكذب. It is impossible to say that there's a possibility that it is not correct. والعياذ بالله. الثاني ما لا يمكن وصفه, ما لا يمكن وصفه بالصدق, that which is impossible to describe as truth. كالخبر عن المستحيل شرعا أم عقلا أو عقلا. مثلا there are certain things that it's just impossible for you to believe. فالأول كالخبر مدعي رسالة. For example, a person claims to be a prophet, it is not possible to believe in them according to the sharia. Shar'an it is impossible for them to be telling the truth. والثاني, the second is كالخبر عن اجتماع النقيضين, كالحركة والسكون في آن واحد وفي عين واحد في زمن واحد. And that which is impossible to believe is when two things that are ضدان, النقيدان, عفوا النقيدان, that they come into progress at the same time, that you find them at the same time. Movement and being still, being hot and being cold, standing and sitting, they are two opposites. So if a person says I'm standing sitting, it is not even possible to what? Believe that person. So there's no way of it being true. الثالث ما يمكن أن يوصف بالصدق والكذب. الثالث, the third type of كلام or khabar, is that which is possible to say it is true or it is not true. إما على السواء, either because in terms of equal, say والله الله أعلم, it could be true, it could not be true, it may not be true. أو مع رجحان أحدهما, or the fact that you believe one more, like nevertheless this person still takes, you're giving him consideration or giving benefit of the doubt. كإخبار شخص عن قدوم غائب ونحوي. مثلا someone says to you Muhammad, who's been away for the last 2 years, has come back. You're going to believe him, صح? لكن it's very well possible that he's lying. Or maybe he made a mistake. It's also possible, صح? طيب. وقد يكون الكلام خبرا إنشاء باعتبارين. لكن a خبر can be إنشاء from two different ways. From one angle, it can be إنشاء. And one angle, it can be خبر. Meaning, from one angle, it can be described as true or false. And another angle, it is something that is impossible to describe as true or false. كصيغ العقود اللفظية مثل بعت أو قبلت أو باعتبار دلالتها على ما في نفس العاقد خبر وباعتبار ترتب العقد عليها إنشاء. طيب. When someone says to you, I'm going to sell you this car. طيب. I'm going to sell you this car. In reality, what does it mean? You're selling the person this car. In a way, it's information because you could be lying. In a way, it is information. لكن in terms of having the correct حكم or the أحكام that come after it, then it is what? It is insha. Because there's no way of me saying to you, this is my car, I sell it to you, and you buy it to you, and I say, you're lying. Forget about lying, just give me my car and take your money. نعم. وقد يأتي بكلامي, وقد يأتي الكلام بصورة الخبر. لكن كلام can be mentioned in a way that it is a خبر. Statement can come and it is a khabar, where you can say it's true or it is false. وَالْمُرَادُ بِهِ, لكن the meaning is الْإِنْشَاء وَبِالْعَكْسِ, and the opposite goes, لكن due to a benefit. مثال الأول, for example, وَالْمُطَلَقَاتُ يَتَرَبَّصْنَ بِأَنفُسِهِنَّ ثَلَاثَةَ قُرُوءٍ. وَالْمُطَلَقَاتُ, those women that are divorced. يَتَرَبَّصْنَ, they wait, بِأَنفُسِهِنَّ ثَلَاثَةَ قُرُوءٍ. They wait, their waiting period is 3, حيد or طهر. يَتَرَبَّصْنَ, what is that? Is that not khabar? Allah is telling us that they wait. لكن يتربصنا بصورة الخبر. It is خبر, information. والمراد به الأمر لكن فليتربصنا. It is a command telling us that their عدة is that long. وفائدة ذلك and the benefit of تأكيد فعل المأمور به حتى كأنه أمر واقع. And the benefit of that is emphasizing that that is the thing that is wajib upon them. So whether it was to يعني saying يتربصنا أو ليتربصنا, which one is shows more emphasis? يتربصنا. كأنه وقع, is as if it's happened already, and it is as if it is the norm, and it has become the norm. يتحدث عنه كصفة من صفات المأمور. You're talking about as if it is an attribute of the thing that is being commanded. ومثال العكس, and the opposite to that is وقال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا اتبعوا سبيلنا ولنحمل خطاياكم. طيب ولنحمل, فقوله ولنحمل بصورة الأمر, ولنحمل as we shall see in command, it is ولنحمل, we shall carry, ولنحمل. لكن والمراد به الخبر أي ونحن نحمل, لكن the meaning is we're going to carry. Although it looks like you're commanding someone to carry something, لكن it means that they are taking the burden and the responsibility from those that are the wrongdoers. Then the Sheikh says رحمه وفائد ذلك تنزيل شيء المخبر عنه منزلة المفروض الملزوم به. So that thing that commanding them to what? That when they're saying they're going to take the responsibility off the shoulders of those people that followed them, it is as if you're making it binding for them to do so, which obviously they cannot do. طيب الحقيقة والمجاز, حقيقة المجاز. This is another مبحث of looking at كلام. حقيقة المجاز. حقيقة simply means when you say something and it is and you actually literally mean it in your wording. And majaz is like a metaphor or words that you use to prove something else. The Sheikh says رحمه الله المجاز, الحقيقة والمجاز. ينقسم الكلام من حيث الاستعمال إلى الحقيقة, إلى حقيقة ومجاز. When we're talking about how to use كلام, it is of two types, حقيقة and مجاز. فالحقيقة هي اللفظ المستعمل فيما وضع له. حقيقة is that wording which is used and it is spoken with or meant by the word that it was initially put there for. You're using it in a way that was the original usage of it, that word. مثل أسد للحيوان المفترس. Why? When you say أسد, أسد has always been known to be what? Or a lion? Lion, the wild animal, the predator. So when you say رأيت أسدا, أو أنا أخاف من الأسد, I fear the Asad. What is going to come to mind quickly, immediately? The lion. فخرج بقولنا المستعمل المهمل. When we say مستعمل, so مستعمل is where? Asad, for example, is a word that is used in its correct usage, what it was originally placed down for. طيب, the Sheikh says وخرج بقولنا المستعمل, that is used, المهمل, that which is disregarded. فلا يسمى حقيقة ولا مجازا, a word that is disregard. مثلا, the example that they say is the word days. Not days in English, D-A-Y-S, لا. دال يا زا. In English, in Arabic, that means nothing, days. The opposite of زيد. Days means nothing. That is مهمل. It carries no meaning. طيب. وخرج بقولنا فيما وضع له المجاز. Because when you're saying using a word in that which is originally placed down for, it excludes what? المجاز, because مجاز is what we're going to see. وينقسم الحقيقة وتنقسم الحقيقة إلى ثلاثة أقسام. What is a حقيقة first and foremost? نعم, using a word in a way that it was always used for. صح, it's correct usage. أسد, صح. السماء, بحر. What is a بحر? Sea, ocean. When you say ركبت البحر, I went by sea, what does that mean? That you traveled by sea. What comes to mind? About sea, normal. صح؟ طيب, the Sheikh says رحمه الله that حقيقة that he's just told you is of three types. حقيقة لغوية, شرعية, عرفية. حقيقة, something that is originally placed in the language, or something that is originally used in the Sharia, or something that is used in the custom of the people. فاللغوية, the حقيقة اللغوية, the حقيقة, the word that is used in a حقيقي way according to the language is what? اللفظ المستعمل فيما وضع له في اللغة. It is the word that is used in the way that it was originally placed in the language, in the language. في اللغة. نعم. فخرج بقولنا في اللغة when we say لغة الحقيقة الشرعية والعرفية. If you say what is used in the لغة originally, it excludes that which is used in the شريعة and that which is used in the custom. مثال ذلك the Sheikh says رحمه الله الصلاة الصلاة فإن حقيقتها اللغوية the original meaning of صلاة linguistically is what? الدعاء فصل عليهم إن صلاتك سكن لهم فصل عليهم دعاء means أي أدعو لهم فتحمل عليه في كلام أهل اللغة. So when you're talking about أهل اللغة, when you're talking to people in the Arabic language, then you use the Arabic language in that in the wordings for that which they were used for initially. صح؟ طيب. مثلا أسد lion is originally placed in the language. طيب. Then the Sheikh says رحمه الله والحقيقة الشرعية. As for the حقيقة الشرعية, when it is what اللفظ المستعمل, the word that is used فيما وضع له in a way that it was originally placed, لكن in the الشريعة. In the شريعة. For example, salah is what? The salah that is known. مثلا عليك الصلاة. يا أخي صلي لله. I say this according to the شريعة. Or you're studying the book of fiqh and it says كتاب الصلاة. What does that mean? كتاب الدعاء؟ لا, كتاب الصلاة. Why though? Because it is used in the شريعة. طيب. طيب والحقيقة العرفية أسف حقيقة عرفية is اللفظ المستعمل فيما وضع له في العرف is the wording that is used according to the custom of the people, according to the custom of the people. For example, مثلا الآن an oyster is what? لا oyster is what? Originally sea animal, seashell or something like that, sea animal, صح؟ طيب. Now if you were to ask someone what an oyster is 25 years ago, immediately they look onto that animal, the sea animal, صح? If you say to someone, give me my oyster today, or if you say to them, get me an oyster, are they going to go to the sea and try to get you an animal? لا. What has that become? حقيقة عرفية, according to the custom of the people. طيب. The Sheikh says, رحمه الله, in the next page, وفائدة تقسيم وفائدة معرفة تقسيم الكلام إلى إلى فائدة تقسيم الحقيقة إلى ثلاثة. What is the benefit of splitting the حقيقة. شوف. What chapter are we on? كلام. What part? حقيقة and مجاز. مجاز we haven't reached. حقيقة is of how many types? Three types. What are they? لغوية, شرعية, عرفية. And we've studied each one. The Sheikh is saying to us now, what is the benefit of this? He says, what is the benefit of knowing this categorization? He says, أن نحمل كل لفظ على معناه الحقيقي في موضع استعماله. So you use every word in according to wherever you it has been used, where it has been used. مثلا you come across salah in the book of fiqh, in a book of fiqh. What does that mean? Salah of the sharia. Salah of the sharia. فيحمل في استعمال أهل اللغة في حقيقة لغوية. So you use it, مثلا whoever you're talking to, if you're talking to the ulama, then you use a word according to the sharia of al-Islam. Then the Sheikh says رحمه الله المجاز والمجاز والمجاز is اللفظ المستعمل is the word that is used في غير ما وضع له in a way that it wasn't originally placed for. مثل أسد, for example, using أسد لرجل الشجاع, for a brave man. It wasn't originally for that. أسد is what? A predator. لكن you're using it as a metaphor, as a مجاز now to refer to a brave man due to something that they have in common. فخرج بقولنا المستعمل المهمل. طيب. وخرج بقول في غير ما وضع له المجاز الحقيقة. ولا يجوز حمل. طيب. This next part is very important to understand. ولا يجوز حمل اللفظ على مجاز إلا بدليل صحيح يمنع من إرادة الحقيقة وهو ما يسمى في علم البيان بالقرينة. When you want to say something is مجاز, there needs to be a قرينة. There needs to be something that points towards it, supporting evidence that shows what you mean. So I can't just say, أخاف من الأسد, or هذا أسد, and then expect me to know, or expect you to know that I'm referring to a brave man. لكن when I say to you رأيت أسدا في المعركة, I saw a lion in the battlefield, what does that mean? I saw a brave man. لكن there's a قرينة here, there's something that shows that I'm not referring to the original usage of the word, rather I'm referring to the majaz usage of the word. What is that قرينة here? في المعركة, in, on the battlefield. The Sheikh says رحمه الله, and that is extremely important because you need to have a dalil that is sahih. And the reason is, مثلا أهل البدعة, they will come across looking to the Quran and the Sunnah and they will say that is majaz. الرحمن على عرش استوى, مجاز. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, لا مجاز. رحمن بلا رحمة, عليم بلا علم, and so on and so forth. ويشتغل لصحة استعمال اللفظ في مجازه. طيب, also another condition is that there has to be something that brings the two together, something that brings the two together, a common ground. طيب, he says رحمه الله وجود اقتباد المعنى بين المعنى الحقيقي والمجازي. There has to be something that brings together the original meaning and the meaning that you're now using it as مجاز. ليصح التعبير عنه ما يسمى بالعلاقة. There has to be علاقة. There has to be a connection. There has to be a connection. For example, مثلا you say to someone, فلان حمار. فلان is a donkey. Do you mean that he's physically a donkey? Sometimes it is referred to as the balid, the one that is a bit dumb, the one that doesn't understand anything. Or when you say fulanun asad, he's a lion, do you mean that he's a predator? لا. لكن the attribute that you're using is the fact that he's brave. You're not talking about other attributes of the lion. You're not saying he's yellow like the lion, or he's white like the lion. You're not saying he uses four legs to walk on. لا. You're saying that he is brave, meaning there's a ilaqa, there's something that brings together the man and the lion, common ground. طيب. طيب. Go to the end, inshallah. Tanbihun, where it says tanbih. Where it says tanbih. Quickly. Go on. روض زاد المستقبل شرح ممتع روضة النظر ابن قدامة explanation of who does ابن عثيمين have explanation of روضة النظر no it's أصول الفقه ابن قدامة it's the one that I studied in but I'm saying does ابن عثيمين have an explanation of it ورقات because if there was an explanation for روضة النظر it would be heaven for all of the students in the كليات. Go on.
So in the case of Shaykh al-Warqat, the Shaykh al-Nu'athaymeen, you mentioned previously that you think, to the best of my knowledge, of the previous opinion that majaz doesn't exist.
استعجلت شوية. It's coming.
Okay.
استعجل تنبيه الشيخ سيد رحمه الله تقسيم الكلام إلى حقيقة ومجاز هو المشهور عند أكثر المتأخرين في القرآن وغيره. Now he's saying, does majaz exist or not? He's saying, majaz existing in the Quran and the Sunnah is what is commonly known among those scholars that are the mutaakhirin, the latter scholars of this ummah. وَقَالَ بِهِ بَعْدَ الْأَهْمَعِ And some of the scholars say, وَقَالَ بَعْدُ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ لَا مَجَازَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ There is no majaz in the Quran. Some scholars say, now he's referring to the khilaf. وَقَالَ آخَرُونَ Some say, لَا مَجَازَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ There is no majaz in the Quran, وَلَا فِي غَيْرِهِ And not even in the Arabic language. So the first one said what? It is not in the Quran. Quran. The second ones they say it is not in the Quran or in the Arabic language in general. به قال إسحاق الإسفرايني ومن المتأخرين. طيب وبه قال أبو إسحاق الإسفرايني ومن المتأخرين العلامة الشيخ محمد أمين الشنقيطي رحمه الله تعالى أو رحمهم الله. طيب so شيخ محمد أمين الشنقيطي الإسفرايني they say that it is not found in the لغة and in the Quran. So they're saying to you يا أخي it doesn't when you say رأيت أسدا في المعركة There's no majaz here. Because the reality is you're referring, I immediately understand what you're referring to. So it's not majaz use. وَقَدْ بَيَّنَ الشَّيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بْنُ تَيْمِيَّةَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَتَمْلِيدُ بْنُ الْقَيِّمِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ اصْطِلَاحٌ حَادِثٌ بَعْدَ انْقِضَاءِ الْقُرُونِ الثَّلَاثَةِ الْمُفَضَّلَةِ ابن تيمية ابن قيم شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية ابن قيم أن الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله they hold the opinion that there's no majaz in the Arabic language. ونصره بأدلة قوية كثيرة تبين لمن اطلع عليها أن هذا قول هو الصواب. So Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah is on the opinion that there's no majaz in the Arabic language or in the Quran or in the Sunnah. طيب. الحمد لله. طيب. وقل رب زدني علما.